We're the squeaky wheels and we need a little grease. Workers and unions, the people of the prole. This is no just war, so let's take control.
Being a radical cheerleader means being able to speak your truth in a way that's thought-provoking, hopefully, by the lyrics of the cheers, and also in a way that's informative.
When I saw people coming out to these protests, you know, in bad weather and in small numbers, I just felt that they needed someone, you know, to congratulate them and thank them. It wasn't until we got closer and closer to possibly invading Iraq that, you know, the tens of thousands of people came out.
Generally, protests are, frankly speaking, really boring. They're just really boring. You know, you're just walking, and that's great. People want to be there, obviously. But at the same time, I don't think there's anything wrong with being entertained and having fun when you're out there.
When there's a group of people who are participating in the rally, they're marching by, and then, you know, maybe they're starting to get a little tired or they're just feeling frustrated about the issues that they're expressing. And then they see the radical cheerleaders who are saying, you know, we're saying like, yay, peacemakers, thanks for being out here. It sort of pumps people up and makes them feel good.
Okay! You ain't got no alibi, you're ugly, George Bush, you're ugly, huh? Unemployment ugly, starving children ugly.
Since protests, I think, often can have a lot of male leaders at the megaphones. And so I think this was a way of getting female voices out there.
In our society, we are told that we have freedom of speech, and yet when we speak up, it's oftentimes thought of as unladylike behavior or uncivilized behavior. So taking a chance and saying what you mean and saying it in a loud voice.
Hey, Kristen, did you know the occupation has got to go?
Do you want war?
What? Do you want war?
No!
Hey, Stella, did you know the occupation has got to go? Do you want war?
What?
Do you want war?
No!
Hey, people, did you know the occupation has got to go? Do you want war?
No!
Cheerleaders started in 1996, and it was started by three sisters, Amy, Kara, and Colleen Jennings of Lake Worth, Florida. They had started cheers that people could take to different cities, different rallies. I think primarily part of it was wanting to have fun, but another part of it was to sort of reclaim protests. There is this sort of change to protesting where people are seeing it as more of a creative way to express themselves.
You know, throughout history, drums and rhythm have just, they just really kind of, they almost tear at your soul. It's like you can't help but be drawn to them.
It's really an important part of the political process for people to express their opinions, and sometimes there's different tactics that people use to do that. Sometimes that's a rally or a march, and being a part of the Radical Cheerleaders, I think, is a way to have fun when you're talking about some pretty serious issues.
Rewind, look back, we did this already. Do you recall? Well, ask your daddy. He'll tell you. 1991, 100 hour war. 1991, 100 hour war. We'll tell you. 2003. War can't make us free. 2003, war can't make us free. This year, 2004, we'll put you out the door. 2004, we'll put you out the door. War won't re-elect you in 1992. Do you recall?
call? Well, ask your daddy. Ask, ask your daddy. Ask your daddy. Ask your daddy.
Radical means that you're able to maybe work outside of whatever is the norm. And certainly, cheerleading at a protest might be something that's a little bit different than what the norm is.
In Nebraska, I might be a radical, but here in Portland, I'm pretty mainstream.
One of the really great things about radical cheerleading is that there aren't any tryouts. You know, you don't have to have fancy outfit. In fact, I think probably there's some idea that you want to have a really crazy funky outfit, which, you know, just involves shopping at garage sales, I guess.
Usually we pick a color, say red, white, and blue, or pink and black, or red and black, and then people just go out and find what they can find and try to be creative and fun, and you know, you can go to whatever extreme that you want. Some people keep it really simple, other people, you know, like to really be extravagant.
We're cute and radical to boot. We're angry, we're tough, and we have had enough. We're sexy, we're cute and radical to boot. We're angry, we're tough, and we have had enough. You're sexy, you're cute and radical to boot. You're angry, you're tough, and you have had enough.
I was never a cheerleader in high school or college, and I never really had a desire to be.
I was a cheerleader in eighth grade for one season, one football season.
I don't like football, and most of the cheerleaders at my school aren't very politically aware, and I wouldn't normally get along with them.
So. I tried out, but I messed up on my cartwheel.
Things didn't really take off in terms of squads proliferating across the country or across the globe until after the WTO protest in Seattle in 1999. There's a radical cheerleading group in Memphis. There's one, I believe, in Atlanta. There's one in Japan and one in Poland. And I think another somewhere in Scandinavia. So they're just sort of all over.
Anybody can do it. You know, we could start up a whole other group if there were enough people who wanted to.
Anyone can do it, anyone of any body shape, any age.
We remember, it was just a year ago. Iraq was bombed, the world said no. We're aware, you said the weapons would be found to distract from oil in the ground. We believe. It's time to take a different tack. Come on, Bush, bring them back!
I would hope that people who have seen the radical cheerleaders and us are seeing that there are different aspects of being a supporter of liberal causes.
It didn't stop the war in Iraq from happening, but I think we still need to get out in the streets and show how much these things matter to us and how dissatisfied we are with them.
Sometimes I'll get an email or when I'm talking to somebody at work, and I may not have seen them when I was out cheering at a rally, but they'll say, hey, was that you and the radical cheerleaders? And if it was, thanks for doing that.
We are so appreciated. I mean, that's what probably is what keeps us coming out. That's what encouraged us to continue after our first protest when, you know, we were pretty nervous. We didn't know how people would react to us, but everyone was so happy to see us and just thanked us and applauded us.
One of the greatest joys of doing cheerleading is that it's fun. You're out there, you're cheering on the crowd and energizing people who are out speaking their truth in regards to peace.
We say peace! You say no! Peace now! Peace now!
Peace!
You say no! are the people, and we declare peace. We're the squeaky wheels, and we need a little grease. Workers and unions and people of the prol, this is not just war, so let's take control.
Thank you.